What's up, everybody? Today is a really cool day because we're starting a brand new series. It's called Your New Playlist. Now, I want you to think about that, and maybe I want you to think about your favorite songs, but there are some songs that you hear or that you've heard before, and they just get stuck in your head. Now, I want you to think back to the last time you babysat your little sibling, or maybe you babysat a little cousin or somebody, or maybe you have a whole babysitting business or something like that, and the last time you babysat, and I'm pretty sure this was the song that keeps playing over and over and over again. Come on, you got it. That's it. And you probably want to sing along, right? Yeah, yeah. See? That's a song that you probably just, you know, plays over and over and over and over in your head. And here's another song I want to play for you, and you can thank me later because I'm taking you back into your childhood, into your younger days. And I know you're going to love this one. Yep, this is the one, right? This is the one. Or maybe you don't know it. Do you? Let's see.
I hopped up the plane at LAX with a dream in my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the
Okay, you pretty much know what that song is. So I know it probably brought back all of the feels, but there's just songs that you probably know. There's songs that I know. There's songs that we know that just play over and over and over in our heads. But today we're going to talk about a different kind of playlist. Today we're talking about a playlist that maybe plays over and over and over in our heads, but it's not our favorite song. Actually, it's our negative thoughts. And here's the truth of the matter. The truth is, all of us at some point in our life, we experience things and situations and bad experiences and disappointments that make us experience these negative thoughts. I know for me, when I was in 10th grade, I was in high school, and my favorite sport is basketball. And so I, in my mind, just knew that I was going to be the star player on my high school basketball team. And so I went to tryouts my 10th grade year, and I kind of walked in with a little bit of a big ego. I walked in with some confidence, a little bit of pride, and I just knew that I was going to make the team until I was cut from that team. And what I realize is that was probably one of the most devastating moments in my life, because I knew for a fact that I was going to be playing basketball for a very long time, and only my second year in high school, and I was cut from the team. So you could just imagine the negative thoughts that played over and over and over in my head. And although there are people that were around me that wanted to support me, I just couldn't stop replaying the negative thought that I'm really not that good enough, or maybe I'll never play basketball again, or I don't like the feeling of rejection. And so all of these things are playing over and over and over in my head. And what I did not realize was that I was heavy on overthinking. I was heavy on overthinking. Did you know that the average person thinks about 70,000 thoughts per day? 70,000 thoughts in a day. Now, I want you to think about your entire year of last year. If you thought 70,000 thoughts per day, that means that over the course of the entire year, you thought over 25 million thoughts. Like, that is insane to think about. And what's even concerning for me, especially when I was in this season of my life where rejection played a big issue, where I felt like I wasn't good enough, where I didn't think that I would ever amount to anything or play on anyone's team ever again because of this, what I perceived as a negative experiences. I wonder how many of those 70,000 thoughts or even 25 million thoughts were negative. And maybe that's the same question that you can ask for yourself. Of the many thoughts that you have in a day and the many thoughts that you had in a year, how many of those thoughts were negative? And if we were honest with ourselves, some of us can admit that there were quite a few of the thoughts that we've had over the course of the day and the course of our year that were very negative. And negative because of a bad experience, negative because of maybe what somebody made us feel like, or maybe it's our self-esteem. And there's a lot of different things that may cause these negative thoughts, but the problem is not so much the situation. I want to spend time on the situation, but I want to spend time on what the situation causes. Because the fact of the matter is that a lot of us, including myself, when we have these negative thoughts, they tend to play over and over and over and over in our minds. And it really becomes the playlist of our life. It really becomes the soundtrack of our life that project who and what we are simply because of what we're contemplating and simply because of what we're feeling. And I know you're a lot like me. Nobody likes to just process and spend time on negative thoughts. As a matter of fact, there's probably times where you've had a negative thought and you were trying to get rid of it, but you didn't know how. Or maybe there are times where you were just having a perfectly fine day. Everything was going exactly the way that you wanted things to go, but then that negative thought came and crashed the party, and that thought was never invited. I'm sure we've had moments like that. I'm sure we've had times where we've wanted to shut the playlist off, but it just keeps playing over and over. So what do we do? What do we do? Even when we have people who support us, even when we have people that say to us, you know, hey, we should stop overthinking. So people that say, hey, it's just all in your head. People that say, hey, it's not that big of a deal. But deep down inside, we honestly feel that it is. I know for me, when I was cut from the team, I mean, it's just a high school basketball team, but for me, it was a big deal. For me, it meant a lot. For me, my status was on the line. My reputation was on the line. I felt like in that moment, my future was on the line. So it was hard for me to stop that playlist from playing over and over and over again. But here's a question that I have for you. What if you could turn the volume down on your negative playlist, on your negative thoughts? And what if there's another playlist that you could play in your mind that would actually be helpful? What if that was the case? What if that was true? Now, the good news is that the Bible has so much to say about the things that we experience in our lives. One of the people that spoke about this was one of the gospel writers. His name was Matthew, and his responsibility really was to write about the life of Jesus. And he wanted to present Jesus as a person that we can depend on when it comes to the things that we experience in life. And so here's what Matthew writes. He actually speaks about a moment that Jesus was speaking on several topics. And here's one of the things that Jesus said in Matthew's gospel. Matthew chapter 6, verse 34. Here's what it says. He says, "So don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring its own worries. Today's trouble is enough for today." And what Jesus is saying in this passage of scripture, in this conversation, is that all of us experience worry to some degree. And for some of us who keep playing the negative thoughts over and over in our minds, worry plays a big role in our lives because we start to think about things that we cannot control. And what Jesus is saying in this verse is that one of the things that none of us can control is tomorrow. And so it does us no good to spend time processing, contemplating, and spending all of our energy and resources and actually making decisions that prevent us from living out our purpose because we're living in tomorrow instead of living into today. And here's even deeper than that. Some of us, maybe we don't live in tomorrow. Maybe we live in yesterday. And maybe we're so hung up on whatever happened in our past that it's hard for us to be present in the moment, present in today. And here's what we can learn from what Jesus is teaching in this moment. We can learn that instead of worrying about yesterday or focusing on tomorrow, that Jesus is reminding us to stay focused on today. Here's what that means for you. Here's what that means for me. It means that we can create our own playlist. It means that you, right now, whatever thoughts that are rolling in your mind, whatever soundtrack is playing in your life, the good news is that you can create your own playlist. You can turn the volume down on negative thoughts, and you can start to replace negative thoughts with thoughts that will be helpful and thoughts that will speak truth to what you're experiencing. Now, I know what you're saying, and I believe it's true as well. It's easier said than done. It's easier to say to get rid of the negative thoughts and to replace them with positive thoughts than to actually do it. But I want to go into something else that Jesus said, because I love what he says in Matthew chapter 11. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 through 30. Jesus understood that we would be in moments of our lives that we would be experiencing these things. And here's what he says about the things that we worry about. He says, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened." Let's just pause right there. Isn't it something that when we're so bogged down with the worries of yesterday and the worries of tomorrow, that it feels like a burden? It feels like we're carrying the weight of the world on our shoulders. And what Jesus is saying is that if you feel this way, the first thing that you should do is come to me. He says, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." One of the other things that we learn about worry is that worry doesn't allow you to rest. It keeps you up at night. It keeps you thinking about things that you shouldn't be thinking about. It keeps you worrying about things that you really can't control. And it keeps you from really experiencing the rest that you need. Physical rest, emotional rest, and more importantly, spiritual rest. And what Jesus is saying is, "Come to me, all who are weary, all who are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." And here's the last thing that he says, "For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Now, I don't know if you know anything about a yoke, but it's more of an agricultural term, and it is what farmers use on their animals in order to move heavy loads of crop, heavy loads of things that they needed to get from point A to point B. So they would put a yoke on two animals, and those two animals would carry the weight and carry the load of grain and carry the load of crops or carry the load of whatever it is that they were pushing. Here's the problem when we worry. When we worry, it is us taking upon the heavy load of life by ourselves. And what Jesus is saying is that, hey, I want to come alongside you, and I want you to place the yoke of Christ, the yoke of Jesus, on your shoulders. Because trying to care and carry the weight of the world on your shoulders by yourself, it is impossible. I'm just going to be honest. It is impossible for anybody to do. And it's only a matter of time before you burn out. It's only a matter of time before you crash and burn. But what Jesus is saying is, "Take my yoke upon you, because my yoke is easy and my burden is light." In other words, what Jesus is saying is that you don't have to experience negative thoughts and negative experiences by yourself. But if you come to me, that I will walk with you, I will talk with you, I will teach you, and you will learn as you go. Now, I want you to think about the unhealthy. I want you to think about the negative thoughts that we experience, and maybe the things that you are experiencing sometimes. And I want you to answer this question. What are you overthinking? What is the thing in your life as a teenager, as a high schooler, freshman, sophomore, as a senior? What are the things that you're overthinking? Are you overthinking what school and what life looks like after school? Are you overthinking what type of friend group and who's going to accept you in your friend group? Are you overthinking what's going to happen in your family, and there's some things that might be changing, and you just can't control it, but you're thinking about it over and over? What are you overthinking? And whatever the answer to that question is, there are some other questions that I want you to start asking yourself. Number one, I want you to ask yourself, whatever you're overthinking, is this thought true? Is this thought true? Is the thing that I am putting my time, effort, and energy on focusing on, is it even true? Is it true that I'm not good enough? Is it true that I'll never amount to anything? Is it true that I will always be a failure? Is that true? Here's another question that you can ask yourself. Is this thought helpful? Is me spending time on a negative thought actually helping me? Number three, the question that you should ask about whatever you're overthinking is this thought kind? Is this thought that's this soundtrack that's playing over and over in my mind, is it causing me to think of myself differently or to think of others differently? And here's the reality. If the answer to any of those questions is no, then that is your sign to turn the volume down on that thought. If it is not true, if it is not helpful, if it is not kind, then that is permission for you to turn the volume down on that negative thought and start to cling to God so that you can replace the negative thought with something so much greater. And here's how you replace the negative thought. Number one, you ask Jesus to carry the burden with you. You pray and you ask, you have alone time with God, and you ask Christ to carry the burden with you. Number two, you replace that playlist, the negative one, with a better one. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm learning a lot about the new music that's out here. And a lot of times when I hear a really good song, I always ask the person, hey, can you share that song with me? And what I do is I take that song and I add it to a playlist. And so I have a playlist on my phone right now that's full of amazing music because I have taken bits and pieces of great songs that others have shared with me, and I have put it together into one amazing playlist. And what I'm saying is that you should do the same when it comes to your life. You should do the same when it comes to the negative self-talk that shows up over and over in your mind. That when you hear from God and when you get support from those that love you, that you take those positive moments and you put together your own playlist. And that's the goal for today, is that you create your playlist. So over the next couple of weeks, we're going to be talking about the idea of this playlist and how it really plays out in our life. But the best thing that we can do and the best thing that we can start today is by creating our own playlist. I want to close with a scripture. It's from Psalm 94, verse 19. And here's what it says. When doubts fill my mind, your comfort gives me renewed hope and cheer. My prayer for you, every freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior, is that you would experience renewed hope and that you would experience renew cheer because you are clinging and depending on the Lord. Let's pray. Father, thank you so very much that we get a chance to come to you anytime that we feel weary, anytime that we feel burdened, anytime that we have a negative thought, that we have the ability to create our own new playlist with the truth of your word and the truth of your promises to us. Thank you and show us what they are. In Jesus' name, amen.